It would be good, if you have such a bucket with lid. If not, you can also use a pot. Let's add some straw. I measured for 300 grams. We will put lime and gypsum. 1.2 grams of lime, 4.8 grams of gypsum. We need to press it so that our material is completely submerged in the water. Inside it is a tool, one of those used when straining yogurt. I have an aluminum plate on it. I will press it, so that the materials do not escape from the edges X, and I will put a weight on it. A stone like this. Let's pour our water now. Everything was submerged under the water. We close the lid without delay. I will put it in a warm environment and wait 2 hours without opening the lid. This is how our sterilization will be, a kind of hot pasteurization. I will wait for 6 to 8 hours, then I will drain the excess water, then it will be ventilated for 1 to 2 hours, by then it will have already cooled down. Now we can use our straw. I'm going to fill 2 bags like this. I have about 100 grams of grain spawn. I will divide it in half, 50 grams per bag. We fill the bags, grain spawn, straw, grain spawn, straw in order, and compressed lightly. We clean the surfaces that we will open holes of the bag with an alcohol napkin or isopropyl alcohol. We will make holes on the bag for gas outlet. We can use a needle and a lighter for this. You know, fire burns everything, including mold spores. We will do it very slowly, calmly. If we do it quickly, the holes we opened may split. Now we will put our bags in a dark environment between 23 and 25 degrees, and we will keep them for 21 days. 2 days have passed and we are looking now. Mycelium has started to grow almost everywhere. It may not be clear from the camera, but I'm looking closely. No mold or any contamination. Today is the 10th day. The mycelium run did not go as fast as I hoped. So I opened 5 to 6 more holes in each of these sides. After that, the winding became a little more accelerated. We did not use wheat bran in these. We will use bran, fuel pellets or sawdust in the videos we will make later. Don't forget to subscribe. I just made this with straw to make it super easy. We'll get mushrooms from these bags. Look. Here, and here, a pin is formed right where the holes are. Let's open a window for them. We opened our windows. Now if we keep them in an environment with a humidity of over 80%, between 85-90%, pins should come from here in 2 or 3 days. Today is the 27th day. As you can see, our pins started coming from where we opened the window. There are also pin formations in places where didn't opened window. We definitely do not open them. If we open it, the energy of the substrate is dissipated, and the pins that came out before do not grow, they will stay small. Normally, mushrooms should only come out of places where we open windows. However, we use transparent bags. Oyster mushrooms can also give pins from places where it sees light. We opened a window here, but the pins did not come from the places where we opened the window. The first pins came out from the side of this bag. They're pretty healthy too. Today is March 13th. It's been 29 days. Mushrooms have grown. The caps are now beginning to curl upwards. Spore release has already started. I think I just made the necessary warning about this issue. There is no point in waiting for it any longer. It will lose its weight now as there is evaporation. Our bag is 518 grams. I'll pluck the mushrooms and weigh them. Let's see how much. 161 grams. Good hardness, good flexibility, and not brittle. This is our second bag. There were curls and stem elongation in the mushrooms. The reason for the stem elongation is the high carbon dioxide rate and I did not light them. The light was insufficient. It was caused by Bag is 717.8 grams. Let's pick our mushrooms and weigh them. (184, 6 grams). When we look at the total, we have grown 346.50 grams of mushrooms. You may remember while preparing the compost, we used 300 grams of straw. We also used 100 grams of seeds, that is, we obtained 346.50 grams of product by using 400 grams of material. This means about 86% of biological efficiency. We did not use bran when growing these mushrooms. We will also use bran in our next experiment. Let's see how much wheat bran will affect the yield. We will see together. If we don't pay attention to the shape of the mushrooms, they are very tasty edible mushrooms. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.